Hello everyone, I'm Jean, the DCM practitioner and instructor in Victoria, BC, Canada. Here is my online class for ENT and eye problems for DCM practitioner and acupuncturist. The book we use I put below here. I can help students to study and review for the class. Let's start.
Okay, let's talk about tonsillitis. So tonsillitis usually is acute one. Usually some people have chronic tonsillitis, like continually in there, but usually is acute one. So acute tonsillitis. So that means, tonsils infections, So that we know the tonsils in the south area, you can see the picture this side, that's the normal, So basically, it's pretty smooth there, a little bit right, but not too right. But when the tonsils swollen, getting bigger, swollen in there, more redness in there, and some the yellow color here means pus. So that kind of acute inflammation happens in the tonsils. So that's what we call acute tonsillitis. This tonsillitis is usually happens in the children. Children have more care, more chance to get the tonsillitis. It usually happens after like people get the common cold and then got the swollen tonsils there. For West medicine, it usually talking about inflammation happens there. Maybe virus, maybe bacterial. So that can cause the severe kind of problems in there. For TCM, we're still talking about external reason with internal reason. External reason is a passenger wind, especially wind heat. And internal reasons is a heat coming from internal organs and the heat rushing up, go to the tonsils area. So that's we're talking about clinical symptoms. So tonsillitis, clinical symptoms, acute one, we say. So acute tonsillitis, we say is usually coming after like a common cold, and then they got a high fever. High fever. So the high fever is around 40 degrees. So we say over 39 degrees that belong to high fever. Over 39 degrees is belong to high fever, but they can reach 40 degrees. And certainly they have symptoms, sore throat. And it's more worse when they slowing down, or maybe difficult swollen and painful there, And the local area, we will check it. It's redness in there and swollen in there in the tonsils, especially in the tonsils. And even some pus, And also, if you touch it, like on the neck area or maybe under maxillary area. So that's even you can find some lymphanodules there. Tiny, bigger, and a little bit sore lymphanodules there. So that's pretty acute problem and pretty severe problems. And also, if you go to laboratory test, white blood cell will be increased. The Zoom changing their pattern now. Not that. So, yeah, either too thinner or maybe too wider pattern. Yeah. The gist changes. And the color of more light. Why do you do that changing? Interesting. Okay, anyway. So that's basically clinical symptoms. Yeah, basically clinical symptoms. Then we're talking about the different type. Yeah, we're talking about different type. So first type, we're talking about the wind heat. Yeah, wind heat type. EPI, wind heat attacking. So certainly we have symptoms, relationship with wind heat. Fever, aversion to cold. Remember, wind heat type is still aversion to cold. It's not aversion to heat. Yeah. So that just means EPI. Yeah, EPI patterns. Yeah, EPI patterns. Both wind cold, wind heat. Will aversion to cold with the fever at the same time. And other symptoms like a headache or maybe running nose, body ache, and certainly they will have sore throat. Yeah, sore throat. And when people try to swallow something down, like eating or even water, the sore throat is more worse. And possible have like some bad smell coming there and more slavery, but mainly locals we can see rhinitis and the swelling in the tonsils. Yeah, truly we can see the big tonsils there. Truly we can see the big tonsils and the rhinitis. So we're talking about maybe some lymphanodules getting bigger also. And the tongue and the tongue, basically we say tonsillitis happens after common cold, like a wind heat type. Basically it's kind of after a couple of days, then their tonsils is swollen. It's not like happens in the first day. So in that case, tongue can change to red. Yeah, tongue can change to red. And maybe little bit yellow tongue coating. Seeing yellow coating. But the pulse, still superficial pulse. External situation still not totally relieved. And the rapid pulse because heat. So that's basically pretty similar with talking about common cold. But especially symptoms go to tonsils area, swollen, rhinitis, painful, even pulse on it. But the pattern still belong to wind heat pattern. So we expel wind and clear heat and relieve the swelling and the tonsils and benefit sort. So that's the wind heat type. So our treatment, yeah, so treatment. So we still have some local points there, yeah, pretty close to the tonsils area, yeah. And we still have some distal points, yeah, distal points. LI4, that still can go to head area. And we have pattern points. We have pattern points. So that's for wind heat. And we have two special points here. We have two special points here. Basically, it's treat thumbs up. Yeah, both these two. You can bleed it for heat condition. You can needle it. Yeah, you can needle it. Certainly, you are not necessary to use both. You can pick up one. Yeah, if you try to bleed it, maybe you better and easily go to round 11 in your points. If you try to needle it, maybe better go to round 10. Round 10 is not that easy to bleed. But these two points treat sore throat is pretty good. Sore throat. So that's they put bleeding under. Yeah, they put bleeding under. You also can bleeding however. Yeah, you can bleeding general points of the lung, or maybe you can bleeding general points of the large intestine. It's a zhang-fu relationship in there, and the large intestine channel still passing like the salt area. And other points, extra points, shixue on top of the fingers, that's 10 points there on both hands. Certainly you are not necessary to needle 10 points. Yeah, you can pick up some of them. So that's for the heat condition. Yeah, heat condition. In the heat pattern. Okay, then we're talking about excessive heat coming from internally. That's mainly coming from the lung and the stomach. So that's basically with these patterns, it's more even severe pain. Even more severe pain. And more lymph nodules, yeah, more lymph nodules. And the pain even go to the ear and the subaxillary area. So more big area, more severe kind of pain. And more rhinitis, swollen of the tonsils. And even with yellow or white kind of pus, like the first picture, yeah. That's so that's basically, then we're talking about the lymph nodules. Yeah, maybe some lymph nodules getting bigger also. So basically internal pattern, internal heat, compared with external pattern, is more severe. Yeah, it's more severe. So we're talking about the severe fever, severe fever. And the internal heat caused thirsty. And even some heat coming from the lung, we're talking about heat especially coming from the lung, patient may be cough and with yellow kind of phlegm and a pretty bad smell, and constipation, and the dark yellow urination. So pretty bad smell, usually we think about that coming from the stomach. So that's why they put the lung and the stomach pattern together. But clinically, we need to see the symptoms. Right tongue, truly, that's internal heat. Right tongue, yellow tongue coating, and the thick tongue coating. And the pretty strong, full lodging, and the rapid pulse. Yeah, so internally excessive heat. Internally excessive heat pattern. So we need to clear away from heat and remove toxin. Excessive heat, most severe, we call that kind of situation, heat toxins. And relieve sore throat, yeah, and relieve swelling. Yeah. or maybe we talk about the style pen in it. So the treatment, yeah, treatment, certainly we're still bleeding it, yeah, still bleeding it, because excessive heat, yeah, excessive heat. So we try to still Jingliao points from the LI11, Lung11, and the LI1, and the Shixuan points there. So clear heat, yeah, reducing heat. And the points, yeah, points, pretty similar. That's local points here, yeah, local points here. And that's distal points here. Then the points, clear heat from the lung and the clear heat from the stomach. That's we say that's a pattern points. And the lung 11, lung 10, still treat sore throat. Still more relieved with sore throat. So that's basically we only add more points, more clear heat from the lung, from the stomach.